We have completed subcontracting thing.
Okay, so today we have to do this consignment process.
Consignment process, yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I think I have explained for what purpose we will do this. This thing we have discussed, na?
No, ma'am.
Okay.
You said you will continue in the second unit.
So theory about this process is not explained, right?
Yes, ma'am. Not explained.
Okay. So what is this consignment process? Basically, see what will happen in the companies. So whenever a product requirement is there, which you usually procure, means say continuous requirement is there for some material. So for that material, you will not, instead of procuring it means frequent time, you can go through the one time quantity. Okay, you will create a type of contract. Basically, it will not be a contract, because in contract you will be means have the things and you will have the ownership. But in this scenario, vendor will be the owner and the stock of that vendor will be into your premises. Okay, so basically it's a type of contract. So for that frequently required material, so you will say to your vendor that we have continuous requirement for this material. So instead of procuring it again and again, so you have sent me the slot for whole the year. Means you can say if you have requirement throughout the year, so you can procure that quantity. Suppose say your estimated quantity throughout the year is say 10,000, 5,000, 20,000, okay, whatever quantity is required. So you can procure that quantity, okay, at one time, and still the ownership will be with vendor only. Okay, so vendor will be the owner for this stock. So what you will do, so you will use that stock according to your requirement and for your use quantity. Okay, you will pay to the vendor. And see, whenever you receive that material, you will not go for the MIGO part. Means MIGO part you will do, you will not go for the MIRO part. So why you will not go with the MIRO part? Because the ownership is with the vendor only. Okay, so vendor you have procured with
what vendor, is MIRO part, ma'am?
Invoicing you will see generally how we proceed. See, we create one PO, then we receive that material. Okay, so when we receive that material, it will be my material. Now I will be the owner of that. Okay, so for that ownership I will pay to the vendor. Okay, so invoicing, basically it will be invoicing, and invoicing we will do through the MIRO depot. Okay, so in that scenario, consignment process, what we will do, see, we know that this material is frequently required in my company, so I will procure it one time, and one time we will have the quantity, bulk quantity. So see, in PO we will order that say 10,000 quantity of some material. So 10,000 quantity will be delivered by the vendor, but the ownership will be the vendor only. Okay, so that's why you will do the MIGO part. Means you will receive that material and you will keep that material into your premises, but again the ownership will be with vendor only. Okay, so you will not be the vendor and you will not have the ownership for that material, so that you will not proceed with the MIRO part. Okay, that means invoicing part. So how you will pay to the vendor? Because whenever you have the vendor stock, so whenever you consume it, you will pay to the vendor. So according to your requirement, say for monthly requirement, you need 200 or 300 quantity of that material. So you will transfer that stock from the consignment stock. Okay, then accordingly you will use that stock, and for that used stock you will pay to the vendor. So basically we will not do here MIRO part. Instead of MIRO part, how I will pay to the vendor? Through the settlement process. Okay, the quantity and the amount for that quantity we will settle. Okay, so instead of MIRO we will do here settlement process. Okay, so this is the consignment process. Yes, now it is clear to you, consignment process?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now I will proceed with the system. So before that, I will show document how we can proceed with.
Ma'am, till now my user ID is not activated.
Okay, same problem is there. So, see, have you? Hello. So have you sent the print screen, means have you posted that error message into group also?
Okay, I posted in the group also.
Posted in the group also?
No, ma'am, I have not posted. And right now I will post it in the group also.
Yes, yes, you post it into the group also so that it can be resolved. Okay.
Okay.
So basically, this is our consignment process. So what we will do for this consignment process, see, first of all, we will create, we will have that material for which we will proceed with the consignment process. Okay. Mm-hmm. So after that, we will have some vendor. Okay. With that vendor, we will procure that material and we will create here PIR. PIR means purchasing info record. Okay. So because we are not paying any amount to the vendor, so we will not enter any amount in the PO also. Okay. Mm-hmm. So if you are not entering any amount in PO, then how I will pay to the vendor and where the price will come? How we will know that this amount we have to pay? So we will maintain that price into the purchasing info record. Okay. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
So in PIR, we will maintain the price. And after that PIR, we will create PR, okay? And with that PR, we will create PO. And with that PO, whenever we do the MIGO transaction, so with MIGO transaction, you will be able to see the T code will be 101 with K category. K means consignment stock, okay? Huh. So once you are not defining any price with the PO or item category, you will go with K. So system will proceed with the MIGO process as 101K category, okay? So now you will receive the material, but ownership will belong to the vendor only. So after that, what you will do, you will go for the good issue. Good issue means now you have the vendor stock, okay? So for your consumption, how you will proceed? See, either you can go for the consumption and either you will go for the, say your, on behalf of some order, like if you have production order, so you will go for the good issue for that production. Okay, so you will issue that material for the production process, and if you have your own consumption, then you will do the good issue for your consumption. Okay, so basically you can proceed this process with two type. Directly you can use the consignment stock for your good issue process. Okay, so suppose you are issuing the material for your consumption, so at that time you will have the cost center. So for cost center, your movement type will be 201, but whenever you use that consignment stock, so you will use it with 201K category. Okay. Mm-hmm. And other way is that from the vendor stock, see, now you have, after GR process, you have the vendor stock. So it will be into your premises. So what you will do, you can transfer that stock into your ownership. Your ownership means you will transfer that stock into your stock. Your stock means unrestricted use. Okay. So you can transfer that stock into your stock, that you can done by your MB1B T code, and MB1B T code you will do by the movement type 411K. Okay. So after this process, whatever quantity you have consumed, for that you will pay to the vendor. How you will pay to the vendor? With T code MRK. Okay, so what is the first thing that we will do? First thing we will do, create a material. Okay, so material we already have. So vendor is there. So now we will proceed with the PIR part. Okay, we will create purchasing info record of consignment. So I'm sharing my screen. So screen is visible to you?
Yes, ma'am.
So how we create PIR through T code ME11. Okay. So this is my vendor. Say my material is this one. Purchase organization. And then enter your plant. Then info record field, you will be keep this field blank. Okay, after saving your info record, you will have the info record number here. Okay, so info category, you will select here which type, consignment type. Okay, so after that, press enter. Okay, see, info record is already created for this combination. Okay, so I will tell you the things by the change option. Okay, so this is the number that is created for this combination. So we will use here ME12 to change this. Okay, so what data we have maintained for this PIR, as you are able to see, reminder system. Okay, that will be 2-day, 3-day, 4-day. And this thing are coming from the master data that we have maintained for this vendor. Okay. So apart from this, press enter and go to the next screen. With next delivery screen time, you will enter here your plant delivery time. Okay. And your purchasing group, then your standard quantity. So I have entered here standard quantity, say 10,000. Okay. So I have requirement of 10,000 quantity of this material throughout the year. Okay, so one more important thing that you will take care here, use the tax code V0. Okay, so what is this V0? So go for the search option. V0 means 0% domestic input tax. Okay, so there will be no input tax as we are not maintaining price with the P. Okay, so for this we will have this tax code. So we have entered this one, and also you will enter here the price. Okay, so price you will enter here with the PIR only. Okay, so take care of these two things. One is your tax code, other one is your net price, right? So apart from that, rest of the data you know how to enter and why you will use. Okay, so now save this. So basically we have created this PIR of consignment type. So copy this, and next process we will create
PIR,
our PIR ME51N. So what you will do, enter here the PIR number. So enter here the plant, storage location,
CM01.
Quantity. So I required this 10,000 quantity. Material also you have to enter here. So my material is this one. Purchase organization. So now we have entered the data. So go for the item category. Enter here. Yes, consignment store. So as we have entered the consignment stock, you can check the item detail section also. So vendor is not mandatory in your PR documents. Okay, so you can leave it or you can. So release strategy is also there for this document. So we need to release this document also, right? So as we have entered all the required data, so check it and save. So I have created PR. Copy this. And what I will do next to release this. So my release code are A1. My next level is A2. And next release is A3. Release proceed. So we have released this. Okay. So now it is ready to proceed. See, if you go with ME53N, display the PR document. So it will show you it is released now. Okay, so now you can access it for your PO also. So, as a reference document, I will enter here the PR number. So, this is my PR data. Okay. So we have entered here item category A also. Sorry, K also. So I think we have entered all the data. So as you can see here, this net price field is not enabled here. Okay, it is disabled. So why it is? Because due to of K category. Okay. So because we are entering here the consignment stock, so we cannot enter here the net price. Okay. So check this. Post. So we have created the PO with this number. So suppose I have ordered this material, now vendor will deliver this material and we will do the GR process. So we will use this MIGO T code. Enter here your PO. So as you can see here in the where tab, system will show you 101 with K category. Okay. So now you are receiving consignment stock. Okay. You can check the quantity and all these things. Go for item okay, go for check and post. So now we have posted the new document also. and we have received this GR document.
Good to repeat.
So what I will do after receiving this stock, I will check my stock. So here my name is BE. This is my material storage location. Execute. And it will show you vendor consignment. Okay, if you check it earlier, so it will show you this 8600 quantity. Okay, so 10,000 is added more here, so it is now 18600. Okay, so now what I will do with that stock? So I will use that stock. Okay, and there are two ways to use this stock. So we will use the we will see here both the ways. Okay, how we can use this stock. Transferring into my stock type, and directly we can use with that stock also. Okay, so first I will see the transfer process into my stock. Suppose this much consignment stock, so I will go to this T code MB1B, and which movement type I will use here? 411 K, right? So this is the location of my stock. So still the ownership is with vendor. So here we have to enter the vendor also. Now it is showing with 411 T code. You are able to see here transfer posting consignment to own stock. Okay. So what is my material? This one. Say I am using this 600 quantity of this. Okay, so we have saved this. Now check the stock. If you refresh here, some issue is there. Actually, it is not transfer.
Yes,
ma'am. I think I have not saved that. So now you have seen my 600 quantity has been transferred into unrestricted stock. Okay, so vendor consignment stock is this one only. Right? So this is the one way we can use here, means we can transfer that stock into my stock type. Okay, from here I can use this stock. Okay, this is the one way. So another way how you can use this stock, you can directly go to the good issue process MB1A. Suppose I want to go for consumption of this material. So whenever I will use this consignment stock, I will enter here the K category. Okay. So for my also I will enter here the cost center, okay, because I am doing the good issue process with respect to cost center. So still the owner is vendor, so we have to enter the vendor also and enter the material. Say 200 quantity I want to go for consumption. Say this. Now it is posted.
Yes.
Check the stock. So now you are able to see another 200 quantity has been moved. So you are not able to see that quantity with the stock. Okay. So how you will check that stock? You will check that stock with MB51. Okay. So another screen you can open. And use T code MB51. My material is this one. Okay, for this vendor and with this material type. Say for a special stock, I want to check the data. So system is displaying you today only we have transferred the 200 quantity. Okay. So with this you can see how we can use this stock. So as we have consumed the stock, so now I will pay to the vendor for this used stock. Okay. So T code I'll use. Slash N So this settlement process we will proceed with the consignment stock and the pipeline stock. Okay. So here I will enter the company code, the vendor. And my plant. Okay, and my material. So first of all we will use this display option. Okay. So what is the consumed quantity is there with respect to this data. So we will see the display. Okay. And we will see here, select here this option, display option, which option you will display here, withdrawals not settled. We will see here that withdrawals which is not settled. Okay. We have used that but we have not paid for that. Okay. So execute this and see the data. So system is displaying the company code, the vendor, the material document. This document is which document through which we have used the stock. Okay. And this is the date, this is the plant, material, your withdrawn quantity. Okay. And amount for this used quantity. Okay. So amount is also there. And your see what is the status of this thing? It is not settled. Okay. So whenever you settle this, you will have the settlement number also. So now we have checked how much quantity we have used. First time we have used 600 quantity and next time we have used this 200 quantity. So we will pay for this quantity. So how I will pay? Go for the settle process. Okay. And withdrawal not settled. Which process you will settle here? The withdrawal that are not settled. Okay. So go for this option and execute. Now automatically in the background system will settle this. Okay. And what is the information here? Document is created, document is created, and this is your settlement document. Okay. So if you open this document, you are able to see the accounting entries with respect to this process. Okay. So what are the process? See, this account will hit, okay, as an account payable. Account payable means what amount you will pay as a settlement. Okay. So this is for your 600 quantity, this is for your 200 quantity. Okay. Because you have consumed the stock in two ways. Okay. So you two type accounting entries will hit, and this much amount you will transfer. Okay. Total of this amount you will transfer to the vendor account. Okay. So this is your vendor account, this is your account payable GL account, right? Is this clear to you? It will show you the settlement. Text is your settlement process. Okay. So settlement for the material document, this one with which you have withdrawn the quantity, right? Mm-hmm. Is this clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
And text code is also displaying here, that is V0.
Okay. Zero plus
and transaction key which are used there, that is your KBS. Okay. So this is how you will check your accounting entries. And if you check your PO number, okay, and see the MIGO document also, what you able to see with your MIGO document. MIGO, see this is my PO, na? So copy this and go for display PO also. MDPN. So I think this is the PO, na, that we have created today, right? So this is my GR number. 1969. But So if we click on this GR document, what it will display you, go to the document info, okay, it will show you the transaction, go for FI document. So system will display you no subsequent document found in accounting because the ownership is still belong to the vendor, okay. So as you have not entered the price and still the owner is vendor, so no accounting document will generate with the MIGO process, right? Is this clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so accounting document will generate only with the settlement process. So that is your complete consignment process. So now it is clear to you the process?
Yes, ma'am. Clear, ma'am.
Clear?
Yes.
Okay. So go for practice for this, okay. And if you have any doubt, any question, you can ask.
Yeah, ma'am. Sure, ma'am. Yes. But I have to start from stocking transit itself.
Sorry?
I did not complete the process of stock and transit itself, ma'am. So after I complete stock.
Okay, you don't have the SAP access right now, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So don't worry about that, you will have the access, okay? Go for the practice, you have this weekend, okay?
Yeah, ma'am.
So
sure.
Start practicing. Today your issue will be resolved. Tomorrow your issue will be resolved, okay? So post this message into the group also and it will be resolved, and after that go for the practice, okay? And if you have any doubt, any question, you can ask with the next class, okay? So okay. Next class we will have on Monday, right?
Yeah, ma'am. Yes.
Okay.